Big data is big. Just how big, you ask? Well, Adi Polak explains how Spark ML on Azure can be used for machine learning at scale using big data. Adi also covers how Spark can be used in AI for Good, a public charity that solves large-scale social issues with artificial intelligence. And finally, Adi explains how a full end-to-end machine learning solution can work with Azure.
Let's start with just one product. What's your favorite product in the machine learning category of or family of things on Azure?
Absolutely. So I really like Spark ML, and you can use it on different products that we have. So if you're working with Spark, you can work with HD Insight, or you can work with Databricks and all this kind of stuff. And right in there, you can integrate Spark ML to do machine learning at scale. And they even have this library named TensorFrames, which is actually TensorFlow with a Spark API. So it's built on top of Spark data frames.
Yeah.
Really fascinating. Really helps to, you know, get things done faster because it builds on top of something that already exists. Yeah.
So I'll just roll back a little bit. What's Spark?
That's a good question. So Spark is an analytics framework to do data analytics at scale. So it's a distributed framework to do analytics at scale. You can do batch processing. You can do stream processing. Depends on what you need.
Yep.
And you can also connect it to different products on Azure, like...
Like ML.
Like ML, like cognitive services, and all those kind of things.
Okay. So Spark ML, is that one product, or is it like a family of things? Like, can you do more than just one thing with it?
So Spark ML is a library that it's open source by Apache Spark. And you can do a lot of different things with that. They don't implement all the machine learning algorithms because there is still a challenge of distributing some of the machine learning algorithms just because the way they are built. But they keep on adding new stuff into it. And it's pretty interesting. And what they're doing now, they're actually building kind of an engine, kind of a framework that other companies can create their own open source, or other communities can create their own open source. They will be able to run it on top of Spark. And you can run all of that in the cloud.
Okay. So what are some of the use cases that people are, or companies or whoever is using, let's say, Spark ML for?
Sure. So all machine learning that you can think of, let's say AI for Good. So recently, they were looking into, there was this situation where white leopards, they thought they were distinct, and they wanted to make sure they have the right numbers of how many white leopards exist. So the thing is, you have to scan like million of pictures.
Yeah.
And for that, you need a lot of people to go over those pictures. But, you know, you don't want to do that. You want to use machine learning. You want to do image processing to figure out how many exist there. Because even in some of the pictures, for us to figure out there's a white leopard there, it's really hard on the background, like the sandy background.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's kind of like you don't see them.
No. Well, that's kind of the whole idea of a leopard, isn't it? You don't see them. So... Yeah, so how does that work? So that's machine learning. You train a model and it does that, or?
So you train a model, you basically build a classifier. They connect it with Bing, so you can go online and search for photos. Okay. So you can actually collect photos from Bing knowing that it's a white leopard.
Yeah.
And this is how they build their data sets. And later on, classification, and they're running it. And it really helps doing things a bit different rather than having human beings sitting there and classifying photo by photo. So.
And it might be a little bit quicker, I would imagine?
A little bit.
So how would I get started with, say, Spark ML or using AI in general?
So depends you want to use the cloud. So for Spark ML, you would need the infrastructure.
Yep.
So there's a few products that support that. You can go with HD Insights and then deploy your Spark cluster. And then basically import Spark ML library and start using it from your code.
Yep.
You can also go to a different product named Azure Databricks. Yep. And on Azure Databricks, it's basically a SaaS product to run Apache Spark workloads.
Okay.
So there you also do an import saying I want to use Spark ML. Or you can config their specific runtime for doing machine learning. Which is quite fascinating because they already made sure everything is performing well for machine learning purposes.
Yep.
So you can pick that, and it's already has built-in Python and all the different libraries, so you won't even need to import them. It's already there.